Okay, good afternoon, everyone. This is Abhinav Bhatt again, your faculty from IHM Gwalior. Today, for your fifth semester syllabus, we will teach you the two menus from the your syllabus style. So we have the two menus here. Here we have the harlequin bread, which you can see the recipe and methods. This is the ingredients: flour 200 gram, yeast 5 gram, salt a pinch, sugar, unsalted butter, blackjack is the color, and water. So these are the ingredients we have. And second, we have the menu crepe souze. The souze means a orange sauce, and crepe is the batter called pancake batter. And this is the ingredients: refined flour, eggs, salt, milk, water, orange, olive oil, butter, sugar. And Corinto is the alcohol. You can use the rum also and lime one. So these are the recipes for today with the ingredients. So today we will going to, firstly we're going to make the harlequin bread process. As you know, every butter, we have honey, and we have yeast solution here. We have caster sugar, we have refined flour, and we have salt here. This is the refined flour, yeast solution, and caster sugar, butter, and honey, and water. So we will start the process accordingly. So now we will take a firstly, it is a up to 200 gram refined flour. So I take it 400 gram refined flour. I will add little bit salt into it. Then I add little bit sugar. Then I mix it firstly proper. Then I make a gap in the center. Add yeast solution. Mix it. If you find the yeast is little bit less, you can add yeast solution again into it. So after the yeast get properly mixed, we will add the water to make a dough consistent level. Make sure your yeast will be properly mixed in every flour so that it will be rise it properly. Now I add little bit water into it to make a dough consistent level. So in this stage, you should wash your hands properly for making the dough as per the scenario of COVID-19. Sanitize your hands, then you can touch the ingredients properly. So we will make this dough for you all. Okay, so our dough is ready here. You can see the harlequin dough which I used in the previous video. So this is the dough for giving the fermentation. Little bit for this, I will show you the, you can use the oil and butter in your own way. Whatever the requirements you have, you can use it. So I used a little bit of oil here inside the dough to give more softness into it. It will give the softness as well as your dough will give the fermentation help also. oil, after you put the every oil in the dough, you should absorb that also inside the dough. Then only it will be get the softness. So we should be very much careful while handling the oil. Don't use too much oil into it. Only for softness, nothing else it will be done. If you find little bit hard, you can put oil. So this will also helps your elasticity in the dough, which gives the gluten more effective. So from your palm only you can generate the elasticity, like I'm doing that. So this is your dough. Now it will go the fermentation stage for rising effect. Your dough is ready, soft, smooth your dough for fermentation going, and it will rise. After that we will give them, we divide the dough into two parts. One part will be added for honey and one part will be added for caramel. So that's why it's called Halley Queen bread. The combination of two coloring agents each other with the two flavor. One flavor is called caramel, that is give the texture called bread little bit brown in texture, and one part is honey that will give the whiteness. Two breads combination form will give the Halley Queen bread texture. Okay, welcome back. So our dough is ready now. You can see the fermentation of dough is done now. Dough has been rised properly and it can show we have made the perfect dough for the fermentation. Now we will drop it into the table and we will give the little bit knock back into this. Knock back is very much necessary so that the air will not be formation. So this is our dough. Now we will divide this dough into two parts. This one part will be called as a honey based and second part will be called as a caramel based, which we use. We have made the sugar caramel, natural sugar, crystal sugar. We have taken it, we make it as a caramel shape. It's also called a burnt shape. Caramelization means last stage of sugar. It is called burnt stage. You can see the texture of this caramel, pure black. It will give the color to the bread. And we will add honey in the second bread. And we will add a little butter. Okay, welcome back. So now you can see the dough level. Consistence of fermentation of two dough. You can see the color here now, which we tell you that caramelization through the help of sugar. We can use the coloring agent to any kind of bread. So you can see the brown texture of one bread and white texture of another bread. You can see the feeling of the one is combination of honey and butter, one is combination of caramelization of sugar that is give the brown texture and little bit butter into it. Now we will mix this both these dough and set in a again proving stage for some time so that it will get the final baking before it will start the process. We'll combine this both these dough in a circular shape and then place it. Okay, you can see through my hand now. If you are comfortable in your hand, then only you can go with the shaping process. If you are not comfortable, first time you are doing this kind of thing, then you definitely should give little bit flour in your table and then put dough into it. Takes time, but you should need be patient little bit. If you allow your patience in your mind, definitely result will be much better. Flour is also evaporates your hand more comfortably. So this is the one dough. I will take my now second dough. Little flour in the top. Now you can see both the breads almost on sheep shape. We will mix it like a finger out of this both. You have to be very much peculiar about your dough. Tight. If you found any extra, then you can remove them. But make sure your dough should be shaped enough to make a formation. If you find any loose content, you can mold it properly. Now I can give the shape of this final. Now I put this in a final shape in the greased mold, which I already did the butter greasing. We'll set it here. Go for the second stage of proving. After it is properly greased, we'll make sure before baking process. I see in the next video. My dear students, pancake, it will be thick in consistency. So, all the best. Learn something, grab opportunity, and give your best shot in your food production life. Thank you.